Hello everyone, my name is Derrick Gillespie, and this is a special feature in honor of former principal of Ferncourt High School in St. Anne, Jamaica, Mrs. Sharon Kelly-Stair.
In news today, concern over mysterious death of 71-year-old Rastafarian elder and former principal of Ferncourt High, Monday in Bull Bay, St. Andrew.
The news hit me like a bomb. And this I can say would be the same feeling of all those who have been connected with Ferncourt High School in St. Anne, Jamaica. Our beloved former principal, Mrs. Sharon Kelly, had died. Raped, robbed, and brutally murdered in her home in St. Andrew, Jamaica. Those who have been connected with Ferncourt High, those who knew Mrs. Kelly through the education system in Jamaica, a stalwart in the education field, will never forget her. The shock will take days, months to wear off. And dear listener, in honor of Mrs. Sharon Kelly, married as Stair, Sharon Kelly Stair, it is my hope that this short video feature will do some justice to the memory of this stalwart, unforgettable Mrs. Sharon Kelly Stair. Principal of Ferncourt High in the green hills of Claremont, St. Anne, Jamaica. Who can forget this lady? Popularly called by the students, Ninja. Because as a serious disciplinarian, you would never know where next she would turn up to instill discipline in the school. Mrs. Sharon Kelly joined the Ferncourt High school family in 1977 as a teacher of Caribbean history. She further advanced into positions of seniority as head of the social sciences department. Then she became vice principal and acting principal from 1981 to 1986. And I may pause here to say it was those years that I was a student under her leadership. She became principal officially in 1987, where she held the position through to 1993. It was then, I must say here, that I myself became a member of staff as a teacher working as her subordinate. Oh, what memories. But I continue. Mrs. Kelly Stair was a stern disciplinarian and often referred to as the ninja by students. She believed in maintaining high standards in discipline and academics. And as such, would have exposed students to science exhibitions and the Jamaica Broadcasting Corporation, now Television Jamaica, School's Challenge Quiz Competition. Mrs. Sharon Kelly-Stair served as the director of the school's debating society, which she ably led to victory, having won the Kiwanis Cup and the Kaiser Cup in Jamaica. Mrs. Kelly-Stair was a passionate activist, always advocating for teachers. Consequently, she became an active member of the National Union of Democratic Teachers, the NUDT. Mrs. Kelly later became the first director of the National Council on Education in August of 1993. Mrs. Sharon Kelly-Stair served the Ferncourt High School and indeed the Jamaican education system with excellence and pride. We will never forget her. Let's go down memory lane to recapture some of the images of this unforgettable lady. Here we can see her with part of the teaching staff, students who passed through the walls of Ferncourt. We'll remember some of these teachers. She was a lady of poise and dignity. Unforgettable. Here we can see her giving one of her famous Sports Day speeches to launch Sports Day at the school. I remember them vividly. Here we can see her having dialogue with a member of staff. Seemed to be the library here. A library which I have fond memories of. And I must take time out to recognize her for being the first person to offer me a job after I left high school. There you can see me on the left, working as a member of the administrative staff. Mrs. Sharon Kelly offered me my first job after I left high school in 1986. I cannot forget that it was this same Sharon Kelly who, as a struggling student, doing my best to excel academically, but coming from a poor background, she was the one who was instrumental in helping me to put together the funds to help my mom to pay for, at the time, what was called the GCE exams, along with a few CXEs. And while working at the school after I graduated as a librarian and also coach of the school challenge team, she was the one who called me to her office, took personal interest in me, and asked me what did I intend to become or what did I want to do with my life. And I wasn't sure at the time, but it was Mrs. Kelly who said she saw the leadership potential in me and recommended that I become a teacher. And it's been 30 odd years since that time, because of the firm guidance and passionate leadership and personal touch of Mrs. Kelly that I went on to become a trained teacher at the revered Jamaica University College. There you can see me in 1991, proudly taking my stand on my way to deliver the valedictory speech at the Jamaica University College, after which my first job as a teacher was at the very same Ferncourt High School. And who else but Mrs. Kelly welcomed me into the bosom of my alma mater, where I taught as a teacher proudly for 5 years. I will never forget this lady, who was one of the factors that shaped my life to become a teacher. I want to pause here now and recognize also another person who has given public testimony of the impact that Mrs. Kelly had on her life. You're looking at Dr. Hume Johnson, who I must say I am proud to have been her teacher while at Ferncourt High, while Mrs. Kelly was principal. This lady has gone on to become an expert in her field of choice. She's a university professor, a life coach, a motivational speaker. And here on Facebook, you can see some of her very many credentials, all coming out from the school that Mrs. Kelly was the leader of. The potential was honed in the great walls of Ferncourt High. And Dr. Hume Johnson has gone on public record to share her personal testimony of the impact that Mrs. Kelly has had on her life, just as she has had on mine. And I'm going to read a little snippet of Dr. Hume Johnson's testimony on Facebook upon hearing of the death of Mrs. Kelly. Dr. Johnson says, "Although Sharon Kelly was my debating coach and not my subject instructor per se, her teaching methodology and the passion with which it was accompanied had a lasting impression on me. She was a giant among educators, a towering presence with unmatched intelligence and class, and a fine example of black womanhood. She had a monumental impact on me, especially the confidence and courage with which she approached the world." And I say, amen. The story changed somewhat in Mrs. Kelly's later years, where she was down on her luck, and sad to say, she became homeless. Rastafarians in St. Andrew, Jamaica, the tribe called the Bobo Shanti tribe, took her in and decided to help her. Past students and one of the principals of Ferncourt High banded together and formed a group called the Ferncourt Friends of Sharon Kelly. There you can see her in the center in her later years, being helped by a grateful school family. On the right is a past student and also a teacher who worked at the school. On the left, we have a past principal and beside her, another of the members of the Ferncourt Friends of Sharon Kelly, who helped her in her later years. While she was being helped by the Rastafarians, she herself took on the Rastafarian culture. There you can see her proudly dressed in her African garb. There you can see her in her final years leading up to her death, doing shopping somewhere in Kingston. But Mrs. Kelly, in her later years, was not without love and support. And there we can see friends. Chances are they might be even members of the education fraternity or persons connected to Ferncourt High. There she is with a past student, somebody who was motivated by her to become a history teacher. Mrs. Sharon Kelly, we love her. We will always remember her. Sleep on. Sleep on. Love you.